evil. Right. It still carries me to this day. Yes. And I'm a woman of a certain age. And I still think about what my mama told
Come
me.
Come on now.
Y'all understand? And it, sometime in the midnight hour, it carries me. But mama said, you can do this.
The heavens. By his knowledge, the depths are broken up, and the clouds drop down the dew. My son, let not them depart from thine eyes. Keep sound wisdom and discretion. So shall thy be life until thy soul, and grace to thy neck.
Mother,
do you have a treasure, mother,
that would amount up to the skies,
that would almost match the sparkle
in your kind, loving eyes? But I have no pearls or diamonds. And I'm sure you're well aware.
So I will give you the gifts
of my precious devotion, love, and care. Now give your mom a great big hand, great big kiss, and hug, and hand clap.
That's for all the mothers.
So I just want to welcome you to Life Changers. This is our first mother-daughter luncheon.
Going on the crowd twice.
And I just want the young ladies to know that they're diamonds of destiny, and the women to know that they're pearls of wisdom, and that those pearls of wisdom, those nuggets, we just want to depart some of those nuggets in you all today. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. So sit back, relax, have a good time. We're going to laugh, we're going to joke, we're going to play some games, and we're going to have a good time and enjoy one another. Amen. Thank you for coming.
Daughter, what's your favorite color? Okay, all right, that's one thing. All right. What's your mother's favorite color?
Blue.
Mom, what's your favorite color?
That's right. It's
blue.
I think that we did that wrong, though.
You did. You supposed to flip it over.
Yeah, when they ask you the question for me, don't say it.
Just flip the sign. Team two, what's your daughter's favorite color? Hold up your answer.
Oh,
hold up, yes.
Yeah, you gotta hold up the answer, you can't say it.
Okay, that's 1 point. What's your mother's favorite color? Mom, what's your favorite color?
Black.
Yeah, that's 2 points.
Good job.
Team three, what's your daughter's favorite color?
I said green, it used to be green.
You have to hold up.
Oh,
just hold the card up. Y'all don't yell the answer out. They have to
you
confirm what you wrote down.
You can't see it, I don't think.
Okay.
I wasn't supposed to
see it.
Oh.
That's your favorite color? Okay. Give a point. What's mom's favorite color? Mom, what's your favorite color?
Brown.
Okay.
What you put?
Purple.
It's Mother's Day. Ooh, it's Mother's Day.
Amazing. Would be amazing. Oh.
Thank you. This is my godbaby, y'all.
Contemporary version, because I like some of this, because it breaks it down for me, not just young people, it breaks it down for me with my old self. It said, God blesses everyone who has wisdom and common sense. You hear what it says? Wisdom is worth more than silver. It makes you much richer than gold. 15 says, wisdom is more valuable than precious jewels. Nothing you want compares with her. 16 says, in her right hand, wisdom holds a long life. You want to live long? Get some sense. Now I'm just taking it like Grandma said back in the day. Y'all don't understand what I'm doing here. Get some sense. That's what she told me. Long life. And in her left hand are wealth and honor. We trying to get rich all the wrong ways. Now I wasn't supposed to stop and talk about all these verses, but I am doing it because that's what the Spirit say to do. With wealth and honor. 17 says, wisdom makes life pleasant. We some miserable people sometimes. Because we don't have wisdom. But listen, we may have it and seen it and observed it and it passed by the door, but we don't apply it. And wisdom leads us safely along. Verse 18 said, wisdom is life-giving, free, a free source of happiness for all who hold on to her. Verse 19 says, by his wisdom and knowledge, we're talking about the Lord Jesus Christ now, he created heaven and earth by his wisdom. His understanding, he let the oceans break and the clouds release rain. And the last verse I'm reading says, my child, use common sense and sound judgment. And then one more, 22. For they will help you live a long and beautiful life. It can't get any better than that. Well, what they're saying to you, and I'm trying to keep my glasses on and off. Don't pay attention to me. They got a secret society here. You know, I see all these things as I pass the channels. Oh, the secret society of the rich and the famous. Y'all know you see that on the TV sometimes. I don't watch it, but I see it as I'm flipping the channels. What you call it, channel surfing? Everything has some type of click or secret. Let me tell you something. You cannot get wisdom from a click.
You sure can. Come on.
You can't find wisdom in fat burgers. You can't get wisdom from a secret handshake. You can't even write a big fat check and buy wisdom. Because it just doesn't come like that. How do you know that, Sister Morgan? Because James 1 and 5 says, if any of you
come on,
lack wisdom, ask God. And my contemporary version says, and he will give it to you. And he is generous and won't correct you or rebuke you for asking for it. This is where wisdom comes from. Anybody can have the highest degrees and all the MAs, the BAs, and the CUAs, and the day-day-lays, and still not have sense enough to tie their own shoes. Now, it sounds silly, but it's real. So it's not all it's chalked up to be unless you have mother wit. That's the other word Grandma used to use. What she was really saying was wisdom from God. Then you can have not one A, B, C, or D. And not even an F. And you could be somebody that was raised in the backwoods and never saw a school door. And be the smartest person that's on your block or in the neighborhood, in the city, anywhere. Because you have allowed God to endow his wisdom on your life. Don't let nobody tell you cheap. Because if you don't have academics that they may have, you tell them I got something that academics can't even touch. Good God Almighty. And her
first lady asked me about nuggets of wisdom. And I began to think about this thing, and I thought, well, she said nuggets. You know, I'm not conventional. I'm always trying to do things out of the box. So I said nuggets. Let me think. And I thought about every baby. Oh, I don't know what the littlest baby is. Every baby in America and Europe, too, now, they can't even read. And they looking up at the golden arches. Y'all know where I'm going with this. They see the golden arches, and they understand that without you telling them anything. So by the time they're able to read and able to speak, the first thing they're saying is McDonald's. Mama, grandma, I want McDonald's. My baby knew what McDonald's was. The granny baby, the youngest grandbaby, will start pointing saying Donald's. He couldn't even say the Mick. I had to figure it out for a long time. You know somebody named Donald? But every child knows what McDonald's is. And then I read a business report that said McDonald's Happy Meals, the McNuggets, was the most dominated advertising thing on TV. The Happy Meals McNuggets. They got the 4-piece, the 6-piece, the 10-piece, the 20. Me and Troy got so excited doing Super Bowl time, they had a 50-piece McNuggets. She said, Mom, she called me on the phone one time. She said, they got a 50-piece McNugget. I said, girl, that's such a Super Bowl. You get inside, you want a McDonald's McNuggets. And I looked at it and I said, well, what am I going to do here? Well, you know, they...
to drink.